Hello, today I'm going to show you how to draw these balloons. First, open a new document, change the stroke to none and the fill to any color you like. Press the letter L for the ellipse tool or select it from the toolbar panel and draw a big ellipse. Now switch to the direct selection tool and drag a box to select these two anchor points. Then press the up arrow key on your keyboard a few times to move them up. Next, switch to the Convert Anchor Point tool. It is hidden under the Pen tool. Now click on the bottom anchor point, hold and drag. While you are dragging your mouse, press the Shift key as well to constrain it. And let's adjust it a bit more. Next, make sure your shape is selected, then go to the gradient window. If it's not open, go to window and select gradient. Choose white and black gradient. Change the type to radial. Open the swatches panel and let's adjust the gradient. Select the black color tab and while pressing down the alt key, choose a different color. Click below the slider to add one more color tab, then click on the white color tab and drag it down to delete it. Now press the letter G to show the gradient annotator on the object and let's make a few more adjustments. In the next few steps, we'll create reflections. Select the ellipse tool and draw a small ellipse. Move it to the top left corner, resize it, apply white and black gradient, and change the type to radial. Let's adjust the gradient. With the small ellipse still selected, go to the transparency window and change the blending mode to screen. If you like, you can adjust the gradient even more. Now we'll make a copy of the small ellipse and place it on the bottom right side. Let's resize it, rotate it, and place it down below. Let's make one more copy and place it over here. Now we need to adjust the gradient. You should be familiar with using the gradient tool. If you would like to learn more about this tool, please check out my other tutorial. And let's adjust the bottom ellipse as well. Next, we'll create a window reflection effect that will look like this. To do that, select the ellipse tool and draw an ellipse. Next, switch to the rectangle tool, click in the center, hold and drag. While you are dragging your mouse, press the alt key as well. Let's duplicate this rectangle. Press the Ctrl and C buttons on your keyboard to copy it and Ctrl F to paste it in front. Next, switch to the selection tool, click on the top right corner, hold and drag. While you are dragging your mouse, press the Shift key as well. With this rectangle still selected, press and hold down the Shift key and select the other rectangle. Now press the Ctrl and G keys on your keyboard to group them together. Next, select both shapes, go to the Pathfinder panel. If you don't have it open, go to Window and select Pathfinder and choose minus front. Next, switch to the Direct Selection tool and drag a box to select the two shapes on the right. Then press the Delete key on your keyboard. Now go to Effect, Warp and choose Arch. Set the orientation to vertical and the bend to 19% and adjust it a little bit more if needed. Now let's place it over here and adjust the position. Next, open the gradient window and choose white and black. This will automatically reset the type to linear. Next, open the transparency panel and set the blending mode to screen. If you like, you can adjust the position and gradient even more. Just use your judgment. Now select everything and let's resize it. Next, we will draw a shape to represent the nut of the balloon. Using the ellipse tool, draw a small ellipse. Let's zoom in, select the anchor point on the top and move it up. Then select the anchor point on the bottom and move it up as well. Let's adjust the curves. With this part still selected, press the letter I for the eyedropper tool and click on the big balloon to get the same color sample. And let's adjust the gradient. Next, select the small ellipse from the balloon and let's make a copy. Now resize it. Right-click with your mouse, select Arrange and bring to front. Let's adjust the size, position and the gradient. Make one more copy and do the same. Select the small shape and group everything together. Select the big shape and do the same. Next, select everything. Open the Align window, make sure Align to Selection is checked, and choose Horizontal Align Center. Now let's join the bottom shape with the top shape. Let's resize it. Finally, we will draw a ribbon. Swap the fill and the stroke, and select white and black gradient. Now select the paintbrush tool, then open the brushes window. If you don't see it, go to window and select brushes. Choose the 5-point flat brush and draw a ribbon. Make sure it is selected, then switch to the eyedropper tool and get a color sample that is the same as the balloon. Now swap the fill and the stroke. Let's zoom in and adjust the curves. Next, select everything and let's make a few more copies. Click on the balloon, hold and drag. While you are dragging your mouse, press the Shift and Alt keys as well. Now press the Ctrl and D keys a few times to make more copies. Finally, we'll apply a different color. Select the second balloon. Now click on the Recolor artwork icon from the top. Then select Edit. Click on the Link Harmony Colors icon and choose any color you like. Let's repeat the same process with the other balloons. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.